The air we breathe has not been clean for a long time. Too many cars, too many emissions. The combustion of diesel produces especially harmful and invisible toxins, nitrogen oxides. They damage the respiratory tract. According to the World Health Organization, 75,000 people across Europe die each year from the consequences. Making the air not just a bit cleaner, but really clean in the future, that's the vision of this man. The Dane Tue Johannessen, together with his team, developed a revolutionary system to eliminate pollutants from diesel combustion already inside the car. A key technology that has numerous benefits. It's an important invention. It not only leads to a very low nitrogen oxide value in the vehicle exhaust, the engine can also run at its optimal operating temperature, leading to a low CO2 value. 15 years ago, Tue Johannessen started doing research while still at the Technical University of Denmark. He's now one of the founders of the company to which the university transferred the patents for commercial development. His colleague, Ulrich Quader, is responsible for research and development, while Tue Johannessen himself is the chief technology officer. This collaboration proved successful as far back as their university days. In the team, they worked on the task of reducing vehicle emissions. Johannessen as a chemical engineer, Quader as a physicist. For this, they wanted to use a gas, ammonia. It can bind and reduce gases. However, for decades, ammonia has been used in power plants to reduce NOx. Ammonia can be processed there in its pure form, but using gaseous ammonia in vehicles poses a big safety risk. In its gaseous state, ammonia is dangerous. No one has yet managed to put it into solid, and therefore harmless, form. Not until now, that is. In 2005, the Danes achieved their breakthrough. They present their magic tablet. Outwardly inconspicuous, but inside, ammonia, tamed. In this solid material, ammonia is bound at the center of the crystal structure. This enables very large quantities of ammonia to be stored. It's almost magical that such large amounts of gas can be bound in solid form. The metallic salt pill, weighing just 1 gram, can store around 0.5 liter of gaseous ammonia. That's invisible to the eye, but it's a sensation and opens undreamt of possibilities. When the firm was founded, one of our first important steps was to enlarge the 1 gram tablet. And here we already have an upgrade to our 100 gram block. And this block contains around 60 liters of ammonia, equivalent to the size of this balloon. And that's not all. The 100 gram block is going to be even bigger and be given a cartridge, making it suitable for use in cars. And now we've reached the point at which the system is mature. It can easily be integrated into vehicles. This cartridge has now been expanded for 4 kilograms of usable ammonia, equivalent to 6,000 liters of ammonia gas. That's equivalent to the balloon that Ulrich is just rolling up here. This balloon therefore contains enough ammonia gas to entirely neutralize another balloon of the same size filled with NOx. Meanwhile, the invention has been patented and further developed and has reached the production stage. Here, we're at the first stage of production. This is where the material that binds ammonia is added to the production. This sack contains 1 ton of salt, which will bind the ammonia later. It's a harmless white powder. The moment the salt reaches the pipes, there's no more daylight. This is a completely sealed system with high quality assurance. The next step in production is the drying process, in which the salt is freed from any moisture content it may have. The next step is the heart of the whole operation. The ammonia comes out of the tank and meets the salt for the first time in this process. Inside this machine, the ammonia and the salt are quickly bound. After this process, the ammonia salt material moves on further into the cartridge. Now we come to the last part of the production line. Here, the container with the finished processed material is welded after it has been filled. Then a further leak test for quality assurance, and the product is ready to leave the factory. Cartridges in bulk. And they've already been successfully launched in buses with diesel engines. Since the system requires little space, the buses can easily be retrofitted with it. A further benefit. We now have 300 buses driving through Copenhagen with clean exhaust emissions. We also have test vehicles stationed in London and have already started trials in the US. And there are test drives underway in Asia too. The results are outstanding. While previous systems to reduce pollution perform poorly in urban driving, the Danes invention reduces up to 99% of nitrogen oxides. That makes it the most CO2-friendly way to drastically reduce NOx emissions and meet future EU emission standards. But how does it work? In exhaust gas aftertreatment using the system, three areas are involved: the diesel engine, the ammonia cartridge, and the catalytic converter. Normally, nitrogen oxides reach the atmosphere almost unfiltered, until now. Via a sensor, the cartridge detects that the engine is heating up and it releases ammonia in a targeted manner. In the catalytic converter, the ammonia meets the NOx emissions. In a chemical reaction, ammonia and nitrogen oxides are converted into water and nitrogen. The harmless mixture leaves the exhaust as humid air. The system is not only extremely effective, but also extremely sustainable. The cartridges last for 10 years. They can be refilled hundreds of times over. This has potential to make a big impact on our air quality. It's important for us and our children. For me, being a father of two sons was also a big motivating factor. After the large diesel vehicles, Tue Johannessen's and Ulrich Quader's invention is now due to be developed for smaller vehicles. A technology for the environment and for humanity that clears the air and sets a whole new benchmark.